form at this point.
Thanks for joining us for the Halftime Report. The second half is about to get started.
Kyrie with the rock. Kyrie Irving, 4 out of 7.
Attack mode isn't a switch that you can just turn on and off. He needs to do more of that. We need to see him penetrate, get into that lane, and create.
LaVine to Porter. A pass taken away by the Celtics. Takes it right to the rim. A lot of contact there, but they say no foul. Simply put, when the ball's in Kyrie Irving's hands, magic could happen.
It's poetry in motion, and it's a situation in which the ball is attached to his body. He has it on a yo-yo. He can put the ball and dangle the ball out there for other people to think they have a chance, and in their mind they do, but in Kyrie's mind, the game is over.
Zach LaVine, he's now 4 for 6.
A two-time dunk champion, I love watching Zach LaVine play. But you can't become obsessed with just attacking the rim. You have to continue to expand your game and really give Chicago that lead guard that they haven't had since D. Rose.
To Irving. For 3, count the triple.
And I don't know why the defense continues to help on guys that drive. Make them take shots over your bigs. By you helping more, you're just leaving 3-point shooters open on the perimeter.
Done. To LaVine. Done. To Zach LaVine. 5 on the shot clock. Shot by Dunn, no good.
It's easy. Force guys into low percentage shots. That's the reason why we're big into stats. It was all provided to you before the game in the scouting report.
Knocked loose. Bulls come away with it. Otto Porter. Not a busy night, but effective. 2 for 2.
There are certain guys in this league that should be put on alert status 24-7. Because either they're posterizing you, or that attempt can still be a poster.
Kyrie lets it go. To Chris Dunn. The pass set it all up.
Ooh, shows like this separate the good players from the great ones. The good players, they have good first halves, and then they fade to black in the second. The great players, they just sustain that kind of dynamic energy throughout the entire ballgame.
Layup's good. Those are the types of shots you always strive for.
So good to see one of Jersey's finest, Kyrie Irving, back on the court and driving with no issues on that knee. He only played 60 games last year, and he missed the entire Celtics postseason run. You can only imagine what this team would have done if he were healthy and they had Gordon Hayward.
Irving into the front court. His guys down 3. To Marcus Smart. A great defense there, forcing the pickup. To Horford. Going to launch beyond the arc. That's good D. Shot no good. Otto Porter. Very efficient and making an impact. He's 3 for 3. Timeout Boston. They'll catch their breath in what's now a 5-point game. Both coaches hitting the reset button. Fresh legs coming onto the floor.
Subbing in for the Boston Celtics.
Irving. Gets a look, can't hit.
I just love where this takes you into the psychological battle as a player offensively. Was that a great contest, or did you just miss the shot? But now you have me thinking about that the entire next possession.
Down to 5 on the 24.
1 minute left in the world.
A drive through the paint, but a shot misses. Ball's controlled by Boston. Tough make through traffic.
You normally don't see that, but that's the type of thing that keeps shooters in the league for a long time. Every once in a while, they venture into the paint.
He was all over him. Missed the shot, no free throws. Another another shot won't go either. Kyrie across the timeline. They're down three. Nothing going here on that drive. Knocks down a tough shot. That was smothering defense.
When the ball's in his hands, we all knew what was going to happen.
Robin Lopez, better late than never. That was his first shot, and it goes down.
Number seven, Timothy Lopez.
Deep three at the buzzer. Three quarters down. The Bulls have the lead. In possession as we start the fourth quarter. Partner, you and I were just shaking our heads during this quarter break. We can't believe how good a game this has been.
And we've seen this so many times with the teams that are the most talented on paper. This shouldn't even be a game. But sometimes an underdog, they rise to the challenge. And they've really hung in there all the way in these three quarters.
Boston with the basketball. To Horford. To Jaylen Brown. Horford. Can't connect from in close. And a pass stolen by Boston.
Tonight, it may not cost you, but in a playoff game, it will.
Short jumper off the mark. Lays it up and in.
There you go. I like seeing his scoring coming from unlikely sources.
To Marcus Smart. Perfect feed to set up the basket.
That's lunch pail business right there. Don't worry about the no call. Keep powering through.
Done to Lopez. Easy pat to the rim.
Contact on a drive can be a beautiful thing. Making those tough shots can really help you build a mental advantage over your defender.
To Horford. There it is, Al Horford. It's been a quiet night. Only three attempts, but he makes that one stick.
Leadership's greatest values occur in between the lines and not necessarily in the box score. And that's the type of leader that Al Horford is. He's the first All-Star free agent to choose Boston in decades. And let me tell you this, the legacy of greatness runs deep in the family. His father, Tito Horford, was the first Dominican basketball player to ever play in the league, which goes to show you why Al has such a great feel for the game.
Play is stopped. Timeout Boston. That's their first. Leaves them with one remaining the rest of the way. Both teams tweaking their lineups. Here comes some changes.
The difference is going to be the best player on the court. He's a guy that you have to trust in. He has to get the ball. And sometimes as a coach, you need to let go and let your best players do what they do.
Kyrie Irving for two. Not that time.
I'm not sure that the contest on the shot contributed to the miss, but what it might have done is seep into the confidence of the shooter that the next time he might decide to try to drive to the rim instead of settling for a jumper.
The ball in the hands of Kyrie Irving to Marcus Smart. Horford probing the defense. Tatum. And it's Lopez there for the rebound. To Porter. Fires the three. Knocks it down and the foul. He's going to the line for a chance at a four-point play.
The most important part for the offensive player is to create space. If you can create space, you can find your rhythm, and that's what we saw.
Chance at a four-point play for his career, 78% at the line. Count that one, and a four-point trip. Kyrie Irving controlling the offense. Here comes the screen to Irving. Shot clock's at five. Down to four. Irving. That one off the mark. It's no good. And the basket good at the rim.
You know, it reminds me, Ed, of a story a legendary coach once told me. He said, if you ever get in a fight, you're not going to hit somebody with an open hand, correct? You'll probably break a finger. But if you hit somebody with a fist, what is that? That's five fingers working collectively together as one. That's how you deliver a knockout punch, and that's what we're seeing tonight.
Done. To Lopez. A bad pass, and the Celtics have it.
You go back to the principles, things that we started working on when we were in first and second grade. It's called the shell drill. You stay down in the stance defensively, you try to deny the next pass away, and you have to communicate. If your conditioning is bad, you have no chance. But if you're able to do all these things together, collectively, you will be able to stop a great passing team.
End score, strong take.
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here yet, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim.
Horford to Hayward. Nothing going here on that drive. Screen coming. Wide open look, won't go.
I don't know why he rushed that shot. He was wide open. Take your time.
Has a look. Knocks it down. Off the step back.
And while the ball was still in his hands, a sidestep throws a defender off. People aren't used to seeing that type of footwork.
To the rim, lays it up and in.
I love the drive to the basket there. Instead of trying to go around or over, go through.
Deep three at the buzzer. That misses with a second to go. The Bulls take this one as they win this one handily. That'll wrap things up. For Jay Williams and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports.
Here we go with the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Bulls were solid in today's victory. You ask me, and I'll tell you, it was the ball movement that made all the difference. There's something to be said for a team that can win as a group, and that's what happened here today. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the Chicago Bulls. The Celtics put up a fight, but didn't get their hands raised at the end. And even though some of them smiled and shook hands with the other guys after the game, you could tell by the way they headed to the tunnels how disappointed they were about this loss. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the Boston Celtics.
Game stats. Player of the game.
And while you can't track leadership on a stat sheet, it was by far the most impressive thing he did in this game. Here we go with the top plays.
Number two. Number one.
See y'all next time. Jalen Rose, signing out.